We are going to discuss about applications of diode. Diode, commonly we talk about PN junction diode, right? So its peculiarity is it allows current in unidirection, okay? So that we have learned about in previous classes, but today we will try to learn few applications of the diode. The first one being rectifier. The second, we'll learn about clippers. Then third, clampers. Okay. Now, first one, rectifier. This is one of the major component which we're going to use daily. Okay, like as you charge your mobile phones, right? So that device is a rectifier. Okay, we will add some regulators to it, and then it will come as your charger. But the main purpose of this one is to convert a alternating current, okay, into a DC current. Okay. So let's take voltage and timer. So this already you know, this is a sinusoidal signal, okay, with voltage. Let us consider 5 volts. Okay. What we are trying to do is we are trying to convert this alternating current into a DC current. It involves different steps. Okay. So first, what we'll try to do with the help of this rectifier, we'll convert into a pulsating DC, and then we'll try to get filtering out this ripples okay, and then with the help of a regulator we'll convert into a DC. So these are the different steps. Okay, slowly we'll go into it. Okay. Now, thus being the summary of the rectifiers, now we'll go to the B. So, rectifiers. Now we do have two types of rectifiers. One is half wave, and second one is full wave. Okay, coming to the half wave, so what it is doing, so as we are taking the sinusoidal as an input, okay, we will see what is the output of this circuit. Now let me draw the circuit of it. Now with the help of a step down transformer, I am going to take the AC signal. Okay. Now, this is connected to the power supply. Okay. It will be around 220 volts. Okay. Now, what I will do is, I will use one diode and take the output at this resistor. Okay. Let us consider 1 kilo ohm. It's a PN junction diode. Okay. So now, what I'm getting is to hear an AC signal. Okay. The input will be the AC signal. Up here, we do have two conditions. One is forward bias and reverse bias. So we will see what is happening in the output when the diode conducts and when it in off state. Okay. The first pulse, as it is in the positive half cycle, the diode will be in forward bias and the current passes through the load. load resistance. Okay, so we will get the output as it is in the positive half cycle. Okay, now in the negative half cycle, what will happen to this diode? It will be in reverse bias. So that means practically it is open circuit. So current doesn't pass through the RL. So we will get 0 volt. Okay. Again, in the next cycle, when the diode turns into a forward bias, okay, it is practically a short circuit over here, and then again the current passes through the RL, we will get the output. Now still, like before I said, there are stages, right? What I am trying to do, to convert into a pulsating DC, but that is not the output which I want. So what, for that one, what we are going to do is, we are going for a full wave rectifier. Now, for most of the part, the circuit is similar to the half wave, but there is only one change. That is, I am going to use two diodes instead of one. And then, I am going to connect to load resistance RL, and then will absorb in CRO. Okay. And here I am going to take center tap transformer. We generate 9 volts, 0 volts, and minus 9 volts over here. Okay. Now see. Now we're gonna give, so we're gonna get an AC signal. Okay, in the positive half cycle, diode 1 conducts, okay, and the current will flow to the RL. We're gonna get the output. Okay, now we'll see in the negative half cycle. Negative half cycle, what will happen? As the positive terminal voltage is below the negative terminal voltage, the D1 will go into off state. Okay. And if you see over here, say this will conduct. So D2 will go to the on state. And because of the reversal of the circuit, we are going to get and AC signal again. Again, vice versa. Like in the next cycle, D1 goes to on state and D2 goes to off state, and we're gonna get a signal. So that is what I added over here to the full wave rectifier. Now still I can make it changes, or else I can better that signal. It is not a DC signal yet. Okay. For that one, what we are doing is, we are connecting a capacitor. Now we will see what will happen. So the basic property of a capacitor is to store the charge, right? So what's happening over here is, when it is receiving a voltage, it is charging, and when there is no power supply to it, it will discharge. The basic nature of a capacitor. Now in this case, what will happen is, when the diode is on, or else when it is getting a signal, it will charge to the peak level. Okay. When the voltage, or else the input voltage to the capacitor is below its charging level, what will do? It will discharge. Okay. and then again when it receives the input voltage, it will charge. Again, it will discharge. Charging and discharging. This cycle repeats. Now, how this waveform look like? Now this is not exactly a DC, but it is close to a DC value, right? Now what we'll do is we'll pass this one to a regulator, and then we're gonna get a DC line of, for example, 3 volts. That is how we convert a sinusoidal signal into a DC value. That is one of the applications of your diode. Now comes clipper. Clipper. Okay, what are these clippers actually? So where we can use this one? So while you are studying signals and systems, so we want to test the signal system, right? So the basic signal with which we can test or identify a system function is an impulse. Okay, but we have to make an experiment. If we want to make an experiment, we have to send a different signals to it. Okay, and we want to look its characteristics, output characteristics. So not only sinusoidal signal, impulse or step function, but also different kind of signals. Okay, so for example, I want to send a waveform like this, or else I want to check the system response if I send these signals. But actually we can't generate these kind of signals. Only we can generate a signals like sinusoidal signal, square wave or a triangular wave, right? But we can't generate these kind of signals. But what we can do is, with the help of clippers, we can convert a sinusoidal signal into these. Okay, how? We will see now. The circuit is pretty simple. We will take a function generator to generate a sinusoidal signal. Let us take 10 volts, 1 kilohertz frequency signal. Now, for understanding purpose, I'll just use a diode D1 and a load resistor. Like I tell you can get the output of this one, right? Which we previously discussed. It is simply an amplifier rectifier. So this will be your output, as you already know. Okay, it is also a clipper. What we are doing is we are totally eliminating the negative half cycle. Okay, but I want to vary that clipping level. Now what I will do is I will introduce a voltage source over here. For example, minus 2 volts over here. Okay, now we will see what will happen, how the output changes. Now when we are getting the output and when we are getting zero output, let us consider, see, a sinusoidal signal is coming over here. When the diode conducts, we are getting the output over here. When the diode is in reverse bias, we are getting zero. Okay, that means what actually happening is, The negative terminal of the diode is connected to a ground in the LDR1. So